Getting in exclusive details from Dominica over the Mehul Choksi investigation. Breaking news coming in on the broadcast. Breaking news number one, Choksi's visitation rights have now been restricted in the Dominica prison. Family members will not be allowed to visit him. That's the big breaking news that we're tracking here right now. Joining me on the broadcast is my colleague, Rhythm. Rhythm, we have big breaking news that Choksi's visitation rights have now been restricted in the Dominica prison, and we're given to learn that family members won't be allowed to visit him. What are you picking up on this?
Yes. All right. So, this is the big breaking news that's coming in from Dominica. Let me tell our viewers that what happened is now Choksi is going to be having it very tough to be meeting his lawyers. He's not allowed to meet his family, Chetan Choksi, who's also under heavy surveillance in Dominica. There is no help coming in from the Dominica government to Mehul Choksi. It seems the Indian government's mission that is currently there, which includes the AD and the CBI agency, it includes the MEA diplomatic mission, as well as the legal team that is being headed by Queen's Counsel and Senior Advocate Hari Salve, are very clear. They are going to ensure Mehul Choksi is dragged back to India. With such a strong push that is being given by the Indian government, it seems only a matter of time that Mehul Choksi is running out of options. Everyone is shocked, even his legal team, as to how the Dominican government has started enforcing this kind of a crackdown on Mehul Choksi. He's currently in prison, which means he's in the hospital owing to his health conditions, according to his lawyers. But actually, he's facing his first taste of prison, and now certain rights have been blocked. He can no longer meet his lawyers at any time that he wanted. It's only between 9 to 2. It's a very strategic time, because 9 to 2 is the time when lawyers are usually in the court. So very less options will be left for Mehul Choksi, because lawyers who are currently working at that time will not be really spending a lot of time with him. Things speeding up in the island nation of Dominica. The Indian government paves the way. Lawyers' meetings are restricted. Choksi is getting no help. His lawyers are not allowed to meet him. There is less access. The timing is extremely critical. Family members, Chetan Choksi, who were there, not only not allowed to meet him, but themselves under heavy surveillance. It's a matter of time that he shall be dragged back to India.
Right, and Rhythm, you also spoke earlier to the Queen's Counsel, Harish Salve. He also said that this is Indian diplomacy at work, and it is only a matter of time that he is deported back to India.
Yes. So Harish Salve, he's leading the diplomatic mission, the Queen's Counsel and senior advocate who knows the laws of the Commonwealth nations. Whether it's the laws in the United Kingdom when Nirav Modi is feeling that there's been a crackdown, or where can see a visible crackdown by the Indian government and can see the efforts and the consequences of that in United Kingdom, or whether it's in the island nations of Dominica and Antigua, all of them being governed by the similar laws are seeing a similar crackdown. Let's also tell our viewers, the ED has done in a remarkable feat more sending back to the banks the money that was owed by Vijay Mallya, by Mehul and by Nirav, and it's a very clear indication to times that are to follow, because what we are seeing in the Mehul Choksi case is, even as the crucial date of 1st July is coming up, his options are running out, his lawyers are not allowed to meet him as much as earlier, he's been trying to make the noises, he's been trying to give out the money allegedly, but everything coming down to one thing, that the lawyers will not be allowed to meet him, his brother, who was earlier meeting him at his whims and fancies, has not been allowed to meet him. He himself is under heavy surveillance, that he does not escape Dominica. So it's very clearly an indication the Indian government that had promised they will drag Mehul back under the Economic Offenders Act also will be able to do so. Let's remember, there are simultaneous, and this is why I believe the Indian government is doing a remarkable job here. There are simultaneous movements that are taking place. A supplementary charge sheet is filed by the ED. The trial court has taken cognizance of it. New sections have been added against Mehul Choksi. Diplomatically, it's a diplomatic coup, because Mr. Harish Salve has said, let's be extremely assured, this is only diplomacy that we are seeing at work in the island nations. And also, these people don't want to be thought of as tax havens. The ecosystem is changing. All this taken together leaves me with no doubt Mehul Choksi is soon going to be getting back on Indian soil, where we welcome him. Arthur Road Jail is ready. Everyone is waiting to welcome him back.
Right. Also, Rhythm, more breaking news coming in on the broadcast. Now, Mehul's brother, Chetan Choksi, who's there, is now under strict surveillance as well.
also, Crispino, I want to tell our viewers that Chetan Choksi is also somebody who has been tracked by Republic TV and our colleague Shravan earlier. He's someone who's always tried to keep very quiet. Even in Dominica, our colleague Ronaldo tried to catch him right in the start. She was one of the very few people who actually was able to track him, even though he refused to say a word. Republic TV was trying to get him to speak. He's always been someone who's not very comfortable speaking to the media, and it's very clear now why, because now he's under heavy surveillance also of the Dominican government. The Indian government is keeping their eyes very, very clear. You see, the kind of story that is building up here in my eyes is very clear, and we can actually map it out on a map. You will see how Indian government is faring here.
Right.
Our ambassadors and our mission people are already present there.
You're, as you rightly pointed out, the Indian government has fast-tracked their effort to bring back Choksi, as his meeting time with lawyers has also now been restricted. That's another news breaker that we're getting here right now, that the lawyer's meeting time with Choksi has also been restricted. Rhythm, what more are you picking up with regards to the meeting of Choksi with his lawyers? It seems that his entire legal defense team is under surveillance as well.
Exactly. So what happens, Crispino, with his meeting with lawyers is crucial, because what happens with that is his Indian lawyers can no longer get him, because the timing is only 9 to 2 p.m. At that time, the Indian lawyers would, the timing does not suit in India because it would be late hours. So he's not able to meet and consult his Indian team, who know exactly what's happening in ground in India where his legal cases are being fought. That is completely out. That strategy cannot now be planned. Now, when it comes to the Dominican lawyers, if you can only meet within the court hours, that means they have less time because they are distracted with their court cases. So it's very systematically being planned that the visitation rights are curtailed. Certain rights are being blocked. The lawyers are bewildered. Choksi is in panic. He knows that things are rounding up in a very clear, systematic pattern. He did not anticipate this. In clear Choksi style, there were news that was coming out that he had tried to bribe certain people of the opposition party. There are no clear references to attribute for now to that. But as Gaston Brown was speaking to us, they don't want Choksi back in Antigua. They believe the citizenship does not belong there. As the Dominican government has spoken to Republic TV, they don't want him present in Dominica. He's also a prohibited immigrant. All these things taken together clearly show that the only place Choksi has citizenship is in India. He should be back here. And both the governments are completely supporting India when they understand that an economic offender, who now India calls an international fugitive, should be back on its land, because international fugitives have only one place, and that is in prison.
Abdul, as you rightly pointed out, international fugitives have only one place, and they have to face the law of the land. Thank you, Rhythm, for joining us on the broadcast. We continue tracking all the latest from Dominica on the Choksi case.